Well, we got an opportunity to autopsy. An automatic gate opener. This is for folks who find opening gates to be a little too onerous. This is a easy gate opener. The title didn't leave much to the imagination there. 350. It's got a picture of a plow horse, but it's not hooked to anything. I'm gonna find out what's going on there. Somebody already did me the favor of removing these screws, and we get inside. And we clearly have ourselves a bit of a battery. There's the go, no-go switch. And judging from all of this crispification, I'm wagering there's a short somewhere. I think that it's a screw drive. That's what I think it is. Which means that underneath here might be a really nice, low-geared, high-torque 12-volt motor. Or 6-volt motor. Whatever that actually is there. So, I can see that being useful. We're gonna see what's inside here. If I'm right, this will be a big drive screw. And if I'm wrong, then I'm gonna wake up all the magic elves. This was given to me to test. And by given me to test, of course, I mean I found it in the dump. Blessed by the rich people, angels, who don't actually bother to fix anything. What do we got there? Phillips? Well, the brand inside, we got the same random plow horse, and it's titled Mighty Mule on top of the circuit board. Which is actually a fully labeled board. Made by Gates That Open, LLC. So it's the Easy Gate Opener 350, produced by Gates That Open, LLC. There you go. Gates That Open, LLC. All the magic. So I got my fingers crossed for a great big high torque, low speed 12 volt motor. That's what I got my fingers crossed for. I'm not hoping to see a great big mess. Did I just say hoping? That's fine. Hoping's close enough to a word. I'm not hoping to see, gonna commit to it, a bunch of plastic gear train. It's got a nose cap here that screws on. Of course, the only way to get it off is to screw out the piston. So we do know it's a gear-driven, some sort of Acme thread screw. Okay. That, I suspect, is some sort of don't kill yourself safety switch. I don't actually see what it's doing. No, it's just some sort of limit switch there. And we got us, I'll bet you that's what's wrong with it right there. I bet I just fixed it. Anyways, we have a Hall effect sensor, magnetic pickup kind of thing going on right here. This board was knocked over sideways a bunch. I bet it cut that whole thing out of line. I think this is supposed to have a washer on top. It's loose. It's really loose. Yeah. I bet you that just fixed it right there. My goodness. But anyways, it has that magnetic pickup. And then down there, yeah, it's got the wheel. Wow. Even their gear train is labeled.
Gates that open.
Fantastic. So much for my idea of a high torque motor. It's just Acme thread and worm drive. But I don't understand is what runs it. It was well used.
You can see that the plastic is pretty eroded where the motor's been vibrating against it. And you can see where it's slung all sorts of grease. It's got a lot of smokiness on these wires right through here. On the on and off switch portion. So it's possible that all the magic smoke got left out of the gate. And once you leave the magic smoke out, then only bad things can happen.
That's the magic smoke hole right there. It's really the only way to find out though. Put power to it. So I put the power supply box,
just the homemade bench supply out of a computer.
Power supply, and she immediately cooked it. Immediately cooked it. So there is a dead short inside the zippity doodah there.
I wonder if I can come up with a way. Spin that fast enough to blow that gearbox apart. I bet you I can. I bet you.